Roman Catholic Church, but how can light fellowship with darkness? How can light commune with darkness? What fellowship has Christ with Belial? What fellowship has God with Baal? There are many Christians who have gotten so famous and rich in the world today, they have bowed their knee to Baal. But hallelujah, praise God. The Lord said, I still reserve myself 7,000 men that haven't bowed their knee to Baal, that still is standing for the truth of the gospel of Jesus Christ. I know you're probably used to hearing this message that God is love, that God loves you, and a part of your sins you can still inherit the kingdom of heaven. But my friend, that's not the gospel of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ declared in the book of Luke chapter 13 verse 3, Jesus said, I tell you nay, but except you repent, you will all likewise perish. What it means to repent, you got to be born again. Jesus said in John chapter 3 verse 3, he said, except a man be born again, you cannot enter into the kingdom of God. And to be born again means that you follow Jesus Christ and you no longer follow sin, that you become a new creation in Christ Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Corinthians 5:17, it says, if any man be in Christ, then you become a new creature. Hallelujah. All things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. There are too many Christians that are satisfied with going to these events, just satisfied going to church every Sunday without living the life of conviction. Where is your conviction tonight? Where is your conviction of the Holy Spirit? Where is your conviction in living a lifestyle of holiness? The Bible declares, let me name the name of Christ, depart from iniquity. Jesus calling us to be set apart from sin, set apart from the things of the world. James chapter 4 verse 4 declares, if you want to be a friend of the world, that makes you an enemy to God. You cannot be a friend of the world and be a friend of a holy God, because God is holy, God is just, God is pure, God is just and out of his ways. We do not commune with sin. We do not commune with the things of this world. Matter of fact, the Bible declares in the book of Corinthians that Satan is the god of this world, and if our gospel be hid, it's hid to them that are lost, and whom the god of this world has blinded the minds of them that believe not. We can't just listen to these preachers. We can't just listen to the TV evangelists. We have to sit down and rightly divide the word of truth. We have to open our Bibles up and make sure that the message that you hear is the message that you can find in the Holy Bible. It's the message of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, who died and rose again on the third day. Jesus Christ is coming back to judge the world in righteousness. The Bible declares in the book of Acts chapter 17, verse 30, that God commands all men everywhere to repent, because he has appointed a day that he's going to judge the world in righteousness. There's coming a day, my friend, when you're going to stand before a holy and a righteous God. How are you living your life every day? Is you living a life of holiness? Have you been born again by the watering of the Spirit? Have you allowed God to cleanse your heart? God said in the book of Ezekiel, chapter 36, he said he'll take that stony heart out of you, and he'll give you a new heart. He'll put his spirit inside of you to cause you to walk in his statutes, to keep his judgments and do them. God wants to give you a new heart. God wants to give you a new mind. You got to renew your mind in the word of God. Stop listening to false prophets. Jesus said in Matthew 7, beware of false prophets. They come to you in sheep's clothing, but inside they are ravening wolves. They are here to deceive you. They paint a beautiful picture of you in this God that they have made up in their mind. A God of love, a God of peace, but not a God of judgment, not a God of holiness, not a God of righteousness. God is a holy God, people. You got to open your Bibles up. Make sure the word that you hear is the word of the living God and not the word of a man, because Jesus is coming again. He's going to judge us. You got an appointment with God. One day you're going to stand before the Lord and give account of your life.